Welcome to Data Science Lovers. In this project, we will analyze the Netflix dataset and we will use these commands and functions: head function, tail function, shape, size, columns, dtypes, info function, value counts function, unique function, and unique function. To remove the duplicates, we will use duplicate function. To find the null values, we will use isNull function. To drop the null values, records, we will use drop any function. We will use isIn function, str.contains function, str.split, toDateTime function, dt.year.valueCounts function. To make the groups, group by function. To draw the bar graph, the count plot, the mean, max, and mean function. And we will also learn how to create new columns, new data frames, and we will apply filtering on single column as well as on multiple columns, and we will use the AND operator as well as OR operator in the filtering. We will also draw the bar graphs using the seaborne library. So let's start. As we have got 5000 subscribers on this channel, so now I have a reward for you, can say free gift, that I will announce in the middle of this video. And next reward will be after completing the 10,000 subscribers. So stay tuned. This Netflix dataset has information about the TV shows and movies that are available on Netflix till 2021. And this dataset is collected from Flixable, which is a third-party Netflix search engine. And this dataset is available on Kaggle also for free. So first of all, we will import our dataset in this Jupyter Notebook. And to import the dataset, we have to use the pandas library. So first of all, we will import pandas library. Import pandas as pd, run it, and the library has been successfully imported. Now we will import our dataset. And to import our dataset, the command is pd.read_, and here we have to write the file type or file extension. My file is in CSV format, so I will write pd.read_csv, and now I will pass the path of my file where it is located on my system. Here is my Excel file. I will copy its path from properties and paste there. Okay, now to remove the Unicode error, we have to write the small r here, and I will save this data set in a data frame, and I am naming it as data only for the easiness of this project. So this is my syntax to load the CSV file. If I run this, the file has been successfully imported. Now if you want to have a look at our data, then I will simply write data here, because we have used data here also. If I run this, then this is my data. Here are 11 columns: show ID, category, title, director, cast, country, release date, rating, duration, type, and description. So these are the columns and these are the rows. It is showing top 5 rows from index 0 to 4 and the bottom 5 rows from index 7784 till 7788. And it is also showing the shape of this data set. Means here are 7789 rows and 11 columns in this data set. Okay. Now we will try to get some basic information about this data set using some small functions or commands. So our first function is head function. So how to use head function? We have to write our data frame name, data.head function. It is used to show the top 5 records of the data set. If I run this, then it will show top 5 records only of this data set. Similarly, we can use tail function. Tail function is used to show the bottom 5 records of the data set. So we can use it, data.tail and function. Run this and it will show the bottom 5 records of the data set. Next we have shape. Shape is used to show the number of rows and number of columns. So the syntax will be like our data frame name dot shape. Here, if you notice, there are no parentheses after the shape command, but in the head and tail there are these brackets or parentheses. So you have to remember these things. If I run this, it will show the total number of rows 7789 and total number of columns 11 from the data set, as it is also shown above here like this. Okay. Next, we can use is size. The size command is used to show the total number of elements in the data set. If I run this data dot size, I run this, then it is showing 85679. Means in this data set total, there are 85679 elements. What are the elements of the data set? This is our one element, this is our second element, this is third, fourth, fifth, and all. So in total, there are 85679 elements in this data set, which can be shown by the size. Next we have is columns. Column is used to show each column name. Suppose we want to have a look at the column names only, then we can use this function, this command only. If I run this, then it will show all the column names. First column is our show ID, second is our category, and fourth is director, and our last column is description. Okay, and it is also showing the data type of the columns. Here all columns are of object data type, object, or you can say string. Next we have is dtypes. This dtypes is used to show the data type of each column. The syntax will be easy. We have to write data dot dtypes. If I run this, it will show the data types of each column. There are 11 columns and it is showing data type of all 11 columns, and all 11 columns have object data type. Next important function is info. The info function is used to show all the information about this data set at once. It will show the indexes, columns, data types of each column and memory at once. And this is the simple syntax, data.info. If I run this, then it will show that it is a data frame, and it will show the indexes. There are 7789 entries, and indexes is from 0 to 7788. And there are total 11 columns. All columns names are shown here. It is also showing the nominal value in each column. In our first column, there are 7789 nominal values. In our director column, there are 5401 nominal values. Means other values are missing in this column. Similarly, it is showing the data type also. And in the last, it is showing the memory uses of this data frame. 669.5 KB is the memory used by this data frame. So this is how we can use some basic functions or commands to get the information about our data set. Now, moving to the next part of this video, we have two tasks here. First task is finding the duplicate records, and second task is finding the null values. As per task 1, is there any duplicate record in this data set? If yes, then remove the duplicate records. To find the duplicacy in the data set, we use the duplicate function. How we will use it? First of all, let's have a look at our data again. I am using data.head to show the top 5 records only. Now, if I see the shape of my data, the shape of my data is 7789 and 11 columns. Okay. Now, how I will check the duplicate records in my data set? The syntax is we have to write our data frame name data, then we will write duplicated and the bracket. Okay. Now, if I run this, then it will show the result in the form of Boolean or true or false. Now, if I want to see the result in required format, then I will use data and the bracket here around this syntax. Okay. So I have to put this command in the square brackets, and before the square brackets, I have to write my data frame name. If I run this, then it will show the duplicate records only from the data set. Here it is showing only two records, means these two records are duplicate in this data set. the index number 6300 and index number 6622. Now we have to remove these two duplicate records from this data. So the syntax to remove the duplicate records or duplicate rows is data dot drop underscore duplicates and function sign. Okay. Now if I run this, then it will show the data frame after removing the duplicate records. As you can see, now two records are less here. Earlier it was 7789, now it is 7787. But these changes are not permanent. To make the change permanent, we have to write a keyword in place equal to true. Now if I run this, then the command has been executed and the changes are permanent now. Means two duplicate records are removed permanently. Now again, if I run this same command that I used here to check the duplicates, here it is showing no result. Means all two duplicates are removed. It is showing only the column names. Or we can also verify by using the shape. If we check the shape of this data set now, it is 7787. Earlier if you see, it is 7789. That's how the duplicate records or rows can be removed from the data set very easily. Our next task is about the null values. Is there any null value present in any column? If yes, show with the heat map. So to deal with the null values in the data set, we use the isNull function. First of all, again I will have a look at my data. Data.head. Now to show where the null value is present, I have to use isNull function. So the syntax will be data.isNull function. This is the syntax to show the null values. Now when I run it, it is showing the result in the form of true and false. When there is a true, means the null value is there, and when there is a false, means no null value is present there. But we want to check how many null values are present in each column. So how we will check? We will simply use the isNull function again, and this time is with isNull function we will use the sum function. So it will show the count of all null values in each column. If I run this, then it will show the count of null values in each column. The first column show ID, it is showing 0, means there is no null value or no missing value. In this column director, there are maximum number of null values 2388, and in the column rating there are only 7 null values. So that's how we can check the null values in our data frame using the isNull function. Next, it is saying that if there is null value, then show with the heat map. So to use the heat map, first of all we have to import the seaborn library, and the syntax will be import seaborn as SNS. This is the syntax to import seaborn library in our Jupyter notebook. If I run this, the command has been successfully imported to show the null values in the form of heat map. We will use SNS dot heat map, and here we will pass our isNull syntax like this. So this syntax will show a heat map with the null values. In this heat map, the null values are shown by this white color. If we check this director column, then this column has the maximum number of missing values. As we can check from here also, it has 2388 null values. And if we talk about the release date column, then there is only single . And if we talk about the country column, then the null values are less as compared to the director column. We can also cross check from here. The country column has 507 null values or missing values. And whenever there is a blank, means there is no null value or hardly any null value, means 1 or 2 or 10. So it will show like this. Let's move to the question part of this project. Our first question is, for House of Cards, what is the show ID and who is the director of this show? This question is regarding the getting the information about a particular element from the data set. So there are two methods to solve this question. First one is using isIn function, and second one is using str.contain function. You will see one by one. If I have a look at my data, data.head, this is my data, and I have to find the details for this house of cards. Now, as you all know, that House of Cards is a TV show and it will be in title column. So we have to consider the title column for this. Now, how we will use isIn function? First of all, we will consider the title column, data and title. This is the syntax to select a column. If I run this, it will show only the title column with the indexes. Now, in this title column, I have to search for a keyword, or you can say string. What I have to search? I have to search House of Cards. So I should use isIn, and after this I have to pass my the element or string that I have to search or look. If I run this, then it will show result in the form of true and false. Means whenever there is a false, this value is not there, and whenever there is a true in this result, this value is present there. Now get the result in the desired format. We will pass our data frame name and the square brackets around this syntax. If I run this now, then it will show the required result. As you can see, the title is House of Cards now, and it is showing the complete record of this element. Now, what was asked? Who is the director and what is the show ID? So we can answer from here. The show ID is S2833 and director is, these are the directors of this show. Next, we can use str.contains also, and the syntax will be little similar. First of all, we will consider our title column, and on this title column we will use str.contain function like this, and here we have to pass the string that we have to search. If I run this, it will show result in the form of true and false, and to get the result in required format, we will pass this syntax in the square brackets. It will show all records of a particular string in any column. If I run this, then it is again showing the same records, House of Cards, and the show ID is this and director is this. Okay, so this is how we can search for a particular element from the data set using isIn and using str.contains. Our next question is, in which year the highest number of TV shows and movies were released, show with the bar graph. This question is related with the date time format. First of all, if I check the data type of my date time column, then it is in the object format. So I will create a new column in the which will contain the date time format. So to create a new column, I will write data, and my new column name, data underscore n, will be my new column name. And what I want in this column, I will write pd dot to date time, and here I will pass my original column name that I want to consider. How I write this syntax? First of all, I have to use the toDateTime function, and in this function I have to pass the original column on which I want to work or I want to consider. So I want to consider this ReaseDate column, and I will save the result in my new column, which will be the date n. Okay, now if I run this, the command has been successfully executed and the new column date n is created. If we see our data set again, then you can see a new column date n is created at the last. And if we want to check the data type of this column, then again we can use data dot dtypes. So if you see that the data type of this column is date time. Okay, now we can easily work on this column. Now, as per our question, it is asking in which year the highest number of TV shows and movies were released. So we can use the value count function for this, and the syntax will be, as we have to work on our new column date and, so I will consider this here, and after this I will use dt dot year dot value counts. Okay, this syntax will count the occurrence of all individual years in the date column. If I run this, then it will show the year wise result. Means in 2019, it found 2153 records, which is the maximum in this data set. And in 2020, it found 2009 records. And similarly, in 2013, there are 11 TV shows and movies that were released. So the answer is 2019. In 2019, there is the highest number of movies and TV shows that were released, and the number is 2153. So using this syntax, we can find the answer. If I tell about the syntax, then we have considered this column first, then we have considered the year only from this date time column, and after considering a year, we have used the value counts. Value counts is used to show the occurrence of all individual elements in any column. Here the element that we have considered is year. So that's how it worked. Now the second part of this question, we have to show it with the bar graph. So the syntax again will be, as we have to consider our new column again, date and we have to consider only the year. So I will write dt dot year. Again, I will use the value counts function. The syntax is same as this, and after this I will draw a plot. Plot kind equal to, what kind of plot I want to draw? I want to draw a bar plot. So I will pass bar here. If I run this, then it will show the result in the format of a bar plot. As you can see, in 2019 it is showing the highest number, and in 2021 it is showing like this number. So we can verify our result from this bar graph also. Okay. There are many other parameters also that we can pass in this bar graph. We are not using these parameters right now, but we will use in our later projects. Our next question is, how many movies and TV shows are in this data set? Show with the bar graph. As I told you, there are many methods to solve a question. I will use group by function to solve this question. First of all, I will have a look at my data again. I am showing only top two records using add and two. Okay. Now I will group by all the TV shows and all the movies from this category column. And the syntax will be our data frame name dot group by function. And in the bracket, I will pass the column name that I want to consider. I have to consider the category column because TV shows and movies are related with this category column. Okay. Now, if I run this, then the groups have created. Now, what results I want from this group by function? I want the count of all TV shows and the count of all movies in this column. So I will use category, my column name, and the count function. So to group all unique items of a column and show their count, we have to use this type of syntax. If I run this, then it will show the result. It is showing the category column has movie items, which is occurring 5377 times, and the TV show item, which is occurring 2410 times. Okay. In this category column, there are only two items. If there is one third item also, then it will show the count of this third item also. But there are only two. So this is how we can use the group by function with count function. Next part is show with the bar graph, means we have to show with the bar graph. So to show the bar graph, we can use the count float function this time, and this is a part of seaborn library. Now as we have already imported the seaborn library above, so we don't need to import it again. We can directly call this seaborn library sns and dot count plot. And which column I want to draw? I want to draw the category column to show the count of all unique values of any column in the form of bar graph. If I run this, then it will show the graph like this, means movies are more and TV shows are less, and we can check the number from here. We can mention the number here also, but we have to add some more parameters here. I am not writing those parameters. I am only showing the use of group by function and the count plot. Friends, it's time for giving free reward gifts. Reward gift is, I am giving you the free notes of core Python. In these notes, there are many commands that you can easily learn and use and enhance your data analytical skills and enhance your skills in the Python. So these are the free notes that I will provide you. To get these notes, you have to just simply mail on our mail ID given on the screen. Next question is, show all the movies that were released in the year 2000. First of all, we will again have a look at our data. In this data, there is a column date N, which is containing the date in the date time format. From this column, we will create a new column that will contain only the year. So to create a new column, the syntax is this data and our new column name. In this column name, what we want? We want only the year from this date and column. So we will write data and the column that we want to consider. We want to consider the column date N, and from this column we need only the year. So we will write dt.year only. If I run this, the new column has been created. If I again have a look at my data, then you can see that a new column year has been created, which is containing only the years 2020, 2016 and all. Now we will apply the filtering to find the answer of this question. We have to find all the movies only, and the year that we have to choose is 2000. So we will apply the filtering. First of all, we will apply the filter for first condition. Our first condition is, we have to find out movies only. Data dot category equal to movie. As you all know, that movie is in the category column. So we are choosing the category column here. This is our first condition. We have to write this in these brackets. And our second condition is about the year. We have to choose the movies that were released in year 2000 only. So we will put our second condition, data year equal to 2000 only. Okay. Now this is our first condition, this is our second condition, and between these two conditions we have to use the AND operator. And to show the result in the required format, we will write our data frame name and the square brackets, and in between these two square brackets we have to put our both conditions. Now if I run this, then it is showing 0, means no movies were released in the year 2000. Now, if we want to check the movies that were released in year 2020, then we can use the same syntax. Only we need to change the year here from 2000 to 2020. We will change. If I run this, then these all are the movies that were released in the year 2020. If you check the category of this result, then all are movies, and if you check the year, then all are 2020. And if we want to see the number of records, there are 1312 movies that were released in 2020. That's how we can create a new column and use the filtering method. Our next question is, show only the titles of all TV shows that were released in India only. Again, this is a question for filtering. Again, we will load our data first, the first two rows only for our reference. And here it is asking for the titles. Means we have to consider this title column of all TV shows. Means we have to consider this column also, category, because TV show is category, and that were released in India only. And we will work on this country column also. Now, to find the answer of this question, we will apply the filter. First of all, we have to apply the filter on the category column to search out only the TV shows. We will write our data frame name, data, and the column that we want to consider, category, and from category we want only TV shows. This is our first condition. We will put in this brackets, and then we have to write our second condition. We have to find the shows that were released in India only. So we will consider the second column as country. In the country, we have to choose only India. So we will filter out the India only. Now, to find the result in required format, we will put our data frame name and the square brackets. And in between these two square brackets, we will put our both conditions. Okay. Now, if I run this, it will show all the records that are containing the TV shows only, and the country is India only. Now, as asked in the question, it is asking to show only the titles. So, to show the titles, we will put the column name here. We have to put the column name title here because it is asking for title only. If I run this, then it will show only the titles of the TV shows that were released in the country India only. That's how we can apply the filters and show the results of a particular column only. We can also put another column name also, like you can say director, or you can say show ID. If I put show ID here, then it will show only the show IDs. Now, the next question is, show top 10 directors who give the highest number of TV shows and movie to Netflix. To answer this question, we will simply use the value count function. First of all, if I have a look my data again, this is my data, and we have to find the top 10 directors. So we have to consider the director column, and to consider a column, we have to write our data frame name, and in the square brackets the column name. Now on this column we will use the value count function. If I run this, it will show all the counts of each unique element present in this column director. Means this role campus Jane Sutter is present 18 times. Means this is the highest number or highest count in this column. J. Karas is present 14 times. Means J. Karas give 14 movies and show in total. Now we have to show only the top 10. So to show the top 10 only, we'll use the head function, and in the head function If I run this, then it will show by default the top 5. If you want to see the top 10, then I will write 10 here. If you want to see the top 15, then I can write top add 15 here. So this is the answer to this question. These are the top 10 directors who give the maximum number of TV shows and movies to Netflix. Next question is, show all the records where category is movie and type is comedies, or the country is United Kingdom. Now this question is a special one. In this question, we will use the AND operator as well as the OR operator in a single line. I will load my data again. Now I have to work on the category column because we have to select the movies only, and we have to work on the type column because we have to select the comedies only, and then we will also work on the country column to select the United Kingdom only. And the syntax for this filtering, first of all, we will use the AND operator between the two condition. First condition is the category should be movie, and our second condition, the type will be comedies. You have to write the exact name, which is comedies. You cannot write comedy, or you cannot write small c here. Now, if I show you one thing, if I run this command, then it will show result in the form of booleans. As I told you many times, that to get the result in required format, with the data frame name and square brackets. Now we have got all the results where the category is movie and type is comedies only, and there are total, if you see, 97 records. Now, as per our question, we have our third condition also. The third condition is the country is United Kingdom. You can say here these two condition is combined into one condition, and now this is our second condition. So here it is showing OR. Then we will use the OR operator. The syntax will be same. I will copy this syntax and paste here. Here I will add the OR operator also. The symbol of OR operator is this single line. And after this, I will write the third condition, which is asking for country. And we have to select the country, United Kingdom. Okay, now what do you think? The records will increase or decrease? If I run this, and if you see, the records has increased to 485. Understand why? Because we have put the our this condition, third condition, using the OR operator. Means either these two condition must be satisfied or this singles condition must be satisfied. If we see here, there will be category movie and the type must be comedy. And if this condition is not satisfied, then the country must be United Kingdom, as you see here. Here the category is movie, but the type is not comedy. But our OR condition is satisfied, which is country equal to United Kingdom. If we see second answer, second record, here the category is movie and the type is comedies, but the country is United States. It is still showing the result because these two conditions are satisfied. Okay, so that's how we can apply the filtering using the AND operator and the OR operator. Our next question is, in how many movies and shows Tom Cruise was cast? This question is regarding finding the information about a particular element from the data set. Same question we have done above. This is my data set, and I have to find all the movies or shows where Tom Cruise was cast. So we have to consider the cast column here to answer this question. We can simply apply the filtering on the cast column data dot cast. To select a column, we have two methods. We either we can use this types of format to select a column, or we can use like this. Both of these syntax will consider the cast column. It is better to use the square brackets to consider a column whenever there is a underscore or there is a space between the characters of a column name. We can use what type of format. Here I am using this type of format to consider the cast column. Here we have to find the results or show the results where the cast is Tom Cruise. Okay. Now if I run this, it will show the result in the form of true false. I will use my data frame name again. If I run this, then it is showing no result because there is not a single category of TV shows or movies where only the cast is Tom Cruise. This syntax works only when there is a Tom Cruise only in the cast column. No other names should be present with this single name. So it is showing zero results. Now if we use the str.contains function, you can also use this function to find the result of a particular string. str.contains, we have used this function in our above question also. We will write our data frame name. If I run this, then it is showing the error. The error is cannot mask with non-boolean array containing NA and none values. Means this function cannot work on the null values or missing values. Now as it is showing that there are null values in the cast column, first of all we will remove these null values. Then we will try to find the result. To remove the null value records from the data frame, we will use the drop NA function. Okay. And how we will do it? First of all, we will create a new data frame. I am naming it data underscore new. In this data frame, we will drop all the null values from our original data frame. This is my original data frame data. I am using drop NA function. It drops the rows that contains all or any missing values. And after removing all the missing values rows, we have to save the result in our new data frame data underscore new. We will run it. The new data frame has been created. If we have a look at our new data frame, head to. So in this new data frame, there is not a single record where the value is missing. All the records that were containing the missing values have been removed from this data frame. Now we can again apply this str function which was causing the error due to null values. Data here I am considering and I am working on the new data frame. Data new. And we have to consider the cast column, this one. And in the cast column, we have to search for a particular string. So we will use str.contains. And here I will write the string that I want to search. This is the syntax. If I explain the syntax again, we have considered the cast column from our new data frame. On this cast column, we have used the str.contain function to find for a particular string in this column, and we have to find the Tom Cruise. So I am writing it in the round brackets. And again, this condition must be put in the square brackets. If I run this, then it is showing the two records, where you can see the cast is Tom Cruise and the cast is Tom Cruise. Means Tom Cruise was cast in two movies, and these are the two movies. So what you understand with this question? First of all, we tried the filtering to find for a particular element from the data set, but the answer was zero, because this filtering doesn't apply whenever there is a multiple elements in a column. Then we use the str.contains to find this element from the data set. This was also not working because there were none values in the columns. Then we created the new data frame after removing all the null values, and on that new data frame we search again for this particular string and we found the result. Moving to our next question, what are the different ratings defined by Netflix? For this purpose, we will use two functions, anUnique and Unique. If I use anUnique function, then if I show the data again, the ratings is a different column, and we have to find all the values, all the elements that are present in this rating to answer this question. What are the different ratings? So first of all, we will consider this rating column, and from this rating column, what we have to search? We have to search all the unique values. I am using anUnique. It will show all the numbers that are unique. It is showing 14, means there are 14 different ratings that are defined by Netflix. Now, if we want to see all the different ratings, then we can simply use the unique function. Data and our column name, rating, and with this column name, we will use unique function. If I run this, then these are the 14 different ratings which are defined by the Netflix. If you see, it is also considering the null values. So there are two different functions that we can use to find the count and to show the exact result from the column, anUnique and unique. Next part of this question is, how many movies got the TV 14 rating in Canada? Okay. Now we have to work on three columns here. We will apply the filtering here. First of all, we have to consider the movies only. As you know, movies is a part of category column. So we will apply a filter on the category column and we will write movie. Means we need the result related with movies only. This is our first condition. And the second condition is the ratings. It is asking for TV 14 ratings only. We will put AND operator, and we will put our second condition. Second condition is from rating columns. The ratings columns, we have to search for TV 14 only. Okay. Now, to show the result, I will use the data frame name here. If I run this, then it will show all the results where the category is movies and the rating is TV 14. Now the question is, how many movies got the TV 14 ratings? Now if we see the shape, then there are 1272 results where the category is movie and rating is TV 14. We have to use the third condition also. because we have to find these results for Canada only. So I will copy this syntax and we have to apply our third condition also. This third condition is applied with AND operator here because it is not asking for OR, it is asking for AND. So I will consider my country column in the third condition and we have to choose for Canada only. This will show all the results where the category is movies. First condition, the rating is TV 14, the second condition, and the third condition is country must be Canada only. So the country is Canada only. This is how we can use multiple filtering in one single line of code with Python. It is asking for the count, you can say. You can show the complete results as well, and you can show the count also by using the shape, means how many records are there with these conditions. There are 11 movies only where the rating is TV 14 and country is Canada. Okay, next question is similar to this. How many TV shows got the R rating after year 2018? So this is some interesting question. We will apply filtering. First of all, we load data for our reference. Then we will apply filtering on the category column because we have to select the TV shows only. So data and to consider category column. I will write category. What we have to search? We have to search for TV shows only. This is my first condition, and my second condition is we have to search for rating R. So I will consider this rating column again and data rating column. The rating column I have to look, sorry, I have to look for R only. Okay, this is my second condition. To get the result, I will put like this. It is showing all the results where the category is TV show and the rating is R. There are only two records. From these two records, we have to search the record where the year is after 2018. If you see, here it is showing year 2016 and 19. So to get the exact result, I will copy this, which is containing our first two condition, and here I will write my third condition. My third condition is we have to select the year which is greater than or after 2018. Okay, if I run this, it will show only one record where the category is TV show and the rating is R and the year is 2019. That's how we can apply the multiple filtering with the greater than and less than operator also. Okay. Now the next question is, what is the maximum duration of a show or movie on the Netflix? You got the idea that we have to consider the time column here. So let's work. Data dot head. We have to work on this duration column here. Here, if you see, there are different type of duration. Let's see what are the different type of duration data, and we have to consider the duration column here. If you see, I am writing data dot duration. I am not writing like this because both of these syntax will work. And as I told you, to get the unique values from a column, we will use the unique function. So from the data frame data, we have considered duration column, and in duration column, we are finding all the unique values. If I run this, and these are the different durations that are present in this column. Okay, 24 minutes, 11 seasons. If you see, the duration is in different formats, some are in minutes and some are in seasons. So we will, for this question, we can ignore the seasons. We will consider the minutes only, where the result is shown in minutes. Okay. Now, if we check the data types of this column, data.duration and dtype, and it is in the object format, as you can see from here also. First of all, we have to convert this into numeric format. We have to follow some steps, and the steps will be, let's load our data again there also. So the first step is we have to split out the elements of this duration column into two different columns. First column will take out the this numeric value, and second column will take out the this string value. So to create two different columns from a single column, we will use str.split function. And the syntax will be data, and in the square brackets we have to write our two column names. My first column name will be minute, and after comma my second column name will be unit. Okay, so it will be my first column name after a split, and it will be my second column name. And what I want in these two columns, I will consider this duration column, and I have to apply the split function on this duration column. In this split function, you have to pass the separator. Here the separator, if you see, is blank space. So I have to pass the separator, the blank space only, like this. If there is a hash or hyphen, then you can pass like this only in the these quotes, this type of quotes. But here the separator is blank space, so I will pass blank space only. Then we have to pass an argument, expand equal to true. Okay, if I run this, the command has been successfully executed. And to have a look at my new data frame, I will use data.head, and like this. If you see, two different columns, first is minutes and second one is unit, are created here. This minute column is containing all the numeric values, means you can say the values that are before the blank space, and this unit column is containing all the string values, means the values that are after the blank space, means seasons and minutes. Okay, that's how we can create two different columns by splitting a single column. Now we can easily find out the maximum value from this minute column using the max function. So as we have to consider the minute column, we will consider this column. If I run this, then it will show all the values of this column. To find the maximum value, we can use max function very easily, and it is showing the answer is 99. Means as per this data set, 99 minutes is the maximum duration. I don't know this is correct or not, but as per the present available data set, it is showing 99. Similarly, if we want to find out the minimum, then we can simply use the dot mean here to find the minimum value, and 1 is the answer. To find out the mean, we can simply use the mean like this, infinite, because these are all in the form of a object. If I show the data type of this column, then you can see it is object data type, not the numeric. But in this case, we can consider it as a numeric value. Okay. Next question is, Which individual country has the highest number of TV shows? So we have to consider the country column and also the category column, which is containing the TV shows item. Data dot head. We have to consider the which one? The country column. Where it is? This one column, country, and the category column. Now, first of all, I will create a new data frame which will contain only the TV shows. I will name my new data frame as data underscore TV show. What I want in this data frame? I want only the category equal to TV shows, means only the TV shows. If I need to create a data frame with movies only, then I will write movie here. Okay. Now, if I want the required result, I will run this command and a new data frame has been successfully created. To have a look at my new data frame, TV show is the name dot head 2. This data frame contains only the category TV show. Now, on this data frame, we will use the value count function on our country column. So, I will select the country column from this new data frame, and if I use value counts function, then it will show all the results from this country column with the occurrence count of each unique element. United States is present 705 times in this country column, which is the maximum, and India is present 71 times in this country column, means for India there are 71 TV shows present in this record, and for you can say Japan, there are 157 records that are present in this TV show data set. From this result, we have to find the, as per the question, the individual country has the highest number of TV shows. So we have to show the first country only. So we can use the head function for this TV show dot country and dot value counts. And I will use head function here. If I use head function without writing any value inside this bracket, then it will show the top 5 records. But I have to show top first record, then I will write only one here. When I run this, it is showing error because we haven't used the brackets here. Now, if I run this again, it will show United States and the count is 705. So this is the answer, that United States is the individual country which has the highest number of TV shows as per this data set. Next question is how we can sort the data set by year. This is a simple question which will show the use of sort value function. First of all, look our data. And it is asking to sort by the year column. This is the year column by which we have to sort. So, using the sort values function, we will write our data frame name and the function name dot sort values. And in the bracket, we have to pass the column by which we want to sort the data set. We have to pass by year column. So I will pass year here. If I run this, then it will show all the data frame with respect to year column. 2008, 2009, 10, and it is also showing the null values also, the last. Okay. Now, if we want to see the latest year at the top records, then we can use one parameter here, which is ascending equal to false. So I will again use sort value function Then I will use my column name by which I want to sort, and with this I can write ascending equal to false. I am writing ascending equal to false because we have to sort in the reverse order, means in the descending order. If I run this, then you can see now the year 2021 is at the top, then year 2021 21, and there will be also 2020 after this 2021. If we see the top 10 records, all 10 records have 2021, but below there will be more records also. The main purpose of this question is explaining the short values function and using the ascending and descending. By default here we haven't written the ascending or descending. By default it is true, means ascending is equal to true is default. Moving to our next question, this is our last question of this project. Find all the instances where category is movies and type is dramas. Means we have to consider two column, category and type. Or the category is TV show and type is kids TV. Here also we have to consider the category column and type column. But between these two conditions, we have to use the AND operator. And between these two conditions, we also use the AND operator. And between these conditions, this one and this one, we have to use the OR operator. Let's work on it. Data dot head. As per the question, we have to work on this category column and on this type column. Okay. Now, our first condition is category must be movie. So data category, I will select movies. Here you have to write the exact name, the movie, because S is not there. Okay, this is my first condition. I will put in the brackets. And my second condition is I have to select all the records where type is the dramas only. Okay, this is my second condition. I will again put this all condition in the square brackets like this. Now if I run this, then it will show all the result where the category is movie and type is dramas. Okay, I will show only the top two records. Now moving to our second part of this question, which is asking for category is TV show and type is kids TV. Okay, this is also for filtering data, and we have to consider category column. This time it is asking for TV show, so I will write TV show. This is my first condition. I will put in brackets, and as per my second condition, the type must be kids TV. So I will put this second condition also in the brackets, and as usual data frame name square brackets and square brackets close. If I run this, it will show the error, invalid syntax. The error is this element kids TV already containing a single quote, and we are using the single quotes here also. So you have to note that whenever the element containing a single quote, we should write the element in double quotes to avoid this type of error. If I run this now, it will show the result where the category is TV show and the type is kids TV only. Okay, this is our second part of this question. Now we have to combine this condition and this whole condition into one using the OR operator. So it is simple. We will write our first condition, if I copy the same, this is my first condition, which is containing the two condition. And my second condition, which is also containing the two condition in itself. And paste here. I will use the simply the OR operator here. Okay. And again, I will put the data frame name, data, the square brackets, and square bracket close. If I run this, then it will show the required exact result, where the category is movie and type is dramas. If this condition is not satisfied, then we have to search for this condition where category is TV show and the type is kids TV. Okay, so that's how we can find the results with the multiple conditions. If I explain this syntax again, we are applying our first condition to find out the category with movies only, and with this condition we have to look the results where the type is dramas only. Okay, so combining these two condition is making our first condition of the answer. Now we have to find the category where category is TV show and the type is kids TV. So again, combining these two conditions is forming one condition only, which is the part of which is second part of our question. And these two condition we have to separate with this OR operator. Okay, so this is the simple filtering. That's all for this video.